What are the best ways to clean the crevices in a shower door? I know everybody has a shower and everybody has those crevices where the door closes and there's a track of ick. I know, we're going to talk about that today. Hi there, I'm Angela Brown, and this is Ask a House Cleaner. This is a show where you get to ask a house cleaning question, and I get to help you find an answer. Now, today's show is brought to us by Savvy Cleaner Training, and one of the courses we just released was on chemical safety. And we talk about all the different kinds of chemicals and the different pH balances of the chemicals and the safety data sheets and the pictograms and all the things that go along with choosing the right chemicals for your cleaning business. So check it out at SavvyCleaner.com. All right, on to today's show. We have a house cleaner that called in and asked this question.
What is the best way to clean in between the shower doors, the little crevice right there in between the sliding glass shower doors?
All right, the crevices. This is a very interesting topic because there are crevices in the sliding glass doors of your shower, but they're also in your windows. When you open up the windows and there's that window track, it's also there as well. Also, if you have a sliding glass door and you open up that door, like from your living room or your kitchen going out to your back patio, you have that crevice there as well. So how do you clean those? Well, it's a very simple process, but it's four steps. And if we follow the same four steps every single time, then we're going to win the crevice game, okay? So if it is a window in the house, you open up the window, and as you open up the window, there's a bunch of debris that's coming in from the outside and the inside that has collected in that track. It collects on the sides of the windows every time there's a storm or a rainstorm or whatever. So there's always gonna be a bunch of gunk there. The first rule that I recommend and suggestion is that you get a vacuum with a vacuum hose and attachment, and that you vacuum out all of the leaves or the dead bugs or anything that has collected inside that track. Now, in your shower, there's not gonna be leaves and debris and dead bugs. There's just gonna be soap scum. But for the windows, we're gonna vacuum it out with a vacuum attachment. That's step number one. The second step is we're gonna spray it with some kind of a cleaning solution that's an all-purpose spray. So it will go inside that track and we're gonna just loosen up all the gunk. All right, once you've loosened up all the gunk, and I recommend that you do two or three windows at a time so that you can kind of let it set for a few minutes. Because as it sets, it's gonna start dissolving and eating away that junk. Because in the windows, it's usually black and it's usually really icky. All right, then the next thing I have with me, my OXO Deep Cleaning Brush. This is the perfect size for the window tracks in the windows. It's just the exact size that most windows have. So I just brush back and forth, and I have my second OXO brush, which it comes in the same pack. And this one has a rubber spatula on the end. And I'll get up close so that you can see that. So the rubber spatula is not gonna scratch the window ledge, and you can dig in the corners and you can just bring all the stuff out. It's kind of like sweeping the floor. You're gonna sweep everything close and you're just gonna make sure that you scrape the insides of it and whatever. Brush it up so that if there's anything that's stuck on there that's not coming out, once you've soaked it a little bit, it should come right up. Right then, the last step that we're gonna do is a paper towel. And in my apron or in the cleaning caddy, depending on how you work, I have a small screwdriver. And this is just a flathead screwdriver that I use for a lot of things, but most especially for window tracks and shower tracks. So after you've cleaned out the debris, and after you've sprayed it and soaked it, and after you've brushed it and you've loosened everything up and you've moved everything to the middle, I always take my paper towel and I wrap it around the top so that now I have something with a little bit of pressure in it. And because it's a flathead screwdriver, it's gonna go right inside all the corners, and I'm basically gonna dry it all out. When I'm done with this paper towel, it is gonna be completely black, and it's gonna be super icky, and I'm gonna toss that right inside my garbage bin so that I am not transferring that, I'm not washing that on my cloths or whatever at the end of the day. This is already clean because I just used the inside of it inside my paper towel that goes back inside my cleaning caddy or my apron, and I'm ready to go on to the next crevice or a crease. But that is how I do it on windows. Now on shower doors, it's a little bit different because the shower is wet and you've just sprayed everything down. So the same rule applies. You wanna get all the gunk out if possible. Now most of the gunk, like I said, is going to be soap scum. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your all-purpose sprayer or bathroom sprayer or whatever you're cleaning your shower with. You're gonna spray the inside of that track. You're gonna follow the exact same rules that you did on the regular window ledge. OXO Deep Cleaning Brushes, again, this is the right size. but on the window of the shower door, there's a little tiny ledge that curls up and that catches the water and sends it back into the shower so that it doesn't fall out onto the floor. When you open the door, it just doesn't run down and get your floor mat wet. So in that track, the little one that has the spatula on it, it has a pointy bristle and it's much smaller than the first bristle. You see that? So this is the one that we're going to use on that little curved lip. And again, we're going to scrub all of the soap scum out now that we've let it soak for a minute. We're going to use the spatula end of it to dig in all of the corners that we can't reach, that are not easily reached. Then we're going to do the exact same process that we did with the window ledge and the paper towel, where we're going to get our paper towel and we're going to wrap it around the flathead screwdriver. And we're going to go and we're just going to clean up that soap scum. With part of your paper towel, you can go back and you can wipe the glass around the edge. Now, one of the things I want you to be careful of is this is the time that you also check the seal on the bottom of the shower door, because as the door opens and closes, sometimes that seal will slide. And if it slides out, then as you open the door, water will leak out and it will ruin whatever's on the other side of the shower door. So you just make sure that you check the seal at the same time. And make sure also that if the seal is broken or busted, that you leave a note for the homeowner so that they can get that fixed. Because if they think you damaged it, then you got to replace it. And it's not expensive to replace. It's like $1.50. And many homes have a spare roll of it so that they can just slide that in when it breaks. But you want to make sure that you check it just so that it's not leaking or any of those things. But anyway, that is how you clean the crevices of shower doors and window ledges. And the same process applies for glass sliding doors between your living room and your outside. So you just want to make sure that you vacuum first if it's an outdoor ledge, and then you want to spray with your all-purpose sprayer, whatever the spray is that you're using. Then you want to use your OXO deep cleaning brushes to loosen everything up and to scrub anything that's stuck on there. You'll use your spatula for the corners and the edges, and then to wipe everything up, your small screwdriver wrapped in a paper towel. And then you'll dispose of the paper towel when you're done, because this, no matter which job it is, will always be super icky and super gross. All right, that's it. It's a very easy process. I hope that helps a little bit. If it does, please pass this on to a friend. If we've earned your subscription, please subscribe. And until we meet again, leave the world a cleaner place than when you found it.